A couple of weeks ago, I found my dream piano. It is a grand piano, which still has a felt between the hammers and the strings. With an upright piano, you have the strings in upright position, and the hammer, it's the strings, and in between that, you have some felt, which mutes the sound, which I like. But I never knew that there was a grand piano where the strings are like that, flat, and the hammer comes from down here. You can't really put felt between it because you can't reach down there. So actually I think that's the nicest piano I've ever played.
How can the sun shine so cold? Yesterday in Berlin I sat on my balcony at 25 degrees drinking red wine. And then I came here.
Reach the keys, I was starting to annoy my parents, and I probably inspired them to give me some piano lessons. I played classical recitals. I had a pretty strict Russian teacher who would push me a lot. He felt like I was kind of meant to play the piano, and so he made me play these ridiculous classical recitals which have like a big flower pot on stage and the piano, and happens at 8 in the morning. And I wasn't really good at that, so that kind of gave up on me. School still, I only did electronic music, more like house and stuff like that. And then it got more and more abstract and more experimental to a degree where it was barely listenable. And I think then I started just focusing on the piano again, because I got so nerdy with all these possibilities of creating sounds with a computer that I felt it is not efficient. You know, you spend so much time on details to create something mediocre. And the piano was a good way out of that because it's very immediate. And for what the piano says, it's super efficient because you just sit down, you have two hands, and you do something which is complete in itself. To sit down. Usually I get up in the morning, and the first thing I do is I go to the piano and play. And pretty often something good happens, and I press record on my little tape deck. I have a little tape recorder, and then I keep the tapes. And when I start recording an album, I listen back to all these tapes and see if I wanted to work on it a little more. But for that moment, I just recorded that little song, and then I feel I did something good already, and then I can have breakfast. Funny was in Cologne when I played in a church that the promoter got so excited throughout my set that I just heard somebody talking like in the first row somewhere really close to the piano. I was like, weird, I mean everybody's quiet, why would somebody in the first row start talking? And then I finally started hearing my name and talking, Nils, amazing Nils, oh yes, Nils, that's so amazing. And then I saw under the piano, kind of, like, kneeing, the promoter sitting and just encouraging me while I was playing. I was like, yeah, but... So he got too excited and carried away. I had to laugh so hard at that moment. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.